Okay, welcome back again. I was on this particular slide. These are the steps to be followed during second semester, because this is very, very important. As I mentioned earlier, you need to listen this very carefully, because this is what you have to do in the during second semester. Okay, the first step is selection of broad topic. सबसे पहले क्या करना है आपको, broad topic को define, मतलब decide करना है. Now, how you are going to do it? So, as I mentioned earlier, you will be advised to submit option of selecting advisor, research guide, okay? And then what my suggestion would be, because unfortunately it is pandemic, hopefully this pandemic is going to be over soon. You will be coming to the lab, coming to the department, and we'll be having face-to-face session. Whenever you will be in the department, try to visit the research laboratories of all the professors. Try to visit research laboratories of all the professors. Try to have interaction with the research scholars in the respective lab. See what kind of research happening in that respective lab. And you need to see like whether you are interested in that topic. Okay. Instead of selecting guide blindly, my suggestion would be you need to ensure that whatever research which is going on in that particular research lab, it is of your interest. वो आप उसमें interest रखते हो, number one. Number two is like that lab should have good facilities as well. जिस area में आप काम करना चाहते हो, because if that lab doesn't have adequate facilities, then you will be having lot of problem. You are not going to get real experience of research, and then if you are really forget about, because I told you earlier, this is not for doing PhD. If you really want to do PhD, I'm sure like you will be gaining good experience. Like for example, let me tell you. Whatever the MSc student so far have completed research project with me, most of them come up with international publications. They have published their data in Scopus Index journal during their MSc out of this project, and some of them got opportunity to do PhDs abroad as well. Why? Because very recently one student she went to Seoul, South Korea for doing PhD. And she published two research paper during her MSc, and as a result of that, she got opportunity in South Korea to do PhD. So you see here, like this is a kind of platform. This is a kind of platform. Like if you can work very seriously during this 2 years span, and if you can publish your data, if you can, it's not only publication. If you can gain some experience of working on research project, then this is going to be a wonderful platform for you. To get wonderful opportunity outside. Even if forget about outside, if you want to do PhD here, क्योंकि PhD के बाद कम से कम एक साल तो आपका ऐसे ही जाएगा ये समझने में. But like if you are working seriously during your MSc project, then you will be saving your time, and you will be able to generate more number of research paper during your PhD if you do research project very seriously. So what you need to do before you select PhD advisor, or I mean not PhD, like project advisor, you need to visit the laboratory of all the professors, have the interaction with the research scholars, see what kind of facilities they are having, see what kind of research they are doing, and then see whether it is of your interest. Okay, and if it is of your interest, then only you should join that particular research lab. And then you need to see like what kind of research they are doing. Okay, and then out of that, one of the, let us say some professor is working on four different areas. So one of the area would be your broad topic. One of the area would be your broad topic, and then you need to understand fundamentals of that, right? Like read the basics from books, literature, research paper, magazines, and try to get yourself aware about that topic. And then next would be literature review. As I told you how to do the literature review, and again I will give you the example international and national status. After literature review, there would be fine tuning of topic. Yahan par broad topic hoga, and then fine tuned topic aapka aayega, and then you will be able to formulate hypothesis. Uske baad hoga set up objectives, methodology, and then expected outcome and references. This is what you have to do in second semester, and accordingly you have to prepare a document. The document should consisting of these points: selection, broad topic, and then some fundamental of the topic, literature review, fine-tuned topic, hypothesis, objectives, methodology, expected outcome, and references. This document is going to be, you will have to submit this document for examination, and during examination, this document will be reviewed, and you will have to make a PPT presentation of these particular points in the examination during second semester. Okay, now I'm going to give you some example. Example, like first is broad topic. Now, as far as my research group is concerned, we are working on two different main areas, gas sensors and heavy metal ion sensor. Like if somebody is coming to my lab, I always ask student to visit the facilities first, see the facilities, have the interaction with research scholar, and then decide what should be a broad topic of your investigation, right? Whether gas sensor or the heavy metal ion sensor. And then I will be asking question, like why, like if somebody come up with the idea that I want to work on gas sensor, then I will be raising question, why gas sensor? Why you won't want to work on gas sensor? Which gases you would like to detect? What material you would like to do, right? I will be asking many questions, right? Then for that purpose, you will have to read the fundamental, like what is sensor? What are the types of classification of sensors? What are gas sensors? What is the importance of gas sensors? What are different modalities of gas sensor? What are chemiresistor and chempeg modalities, applications of gas sensor, and so on and so forth. These are some of the key questions, right? So once you identify a broad topic, this is just an example. Kuch example main diya, lekin isse bhi aage aap bahut kuch pad sakte ho, lekin this is prominent, mote mote taur pe bataya ki ye aapko padhna hai. Gas sensor aapka agar broad topic hai, toh this you have to read. And then once you read this, then you have to, second step will be literature review. Now for literature review, the first step is you have to identify 10 best journals. Ab kaun se journals honge? Scopus or Web of Science Index journal in your area. Jis area mein, matlab in your area means, like if your area is gas sensor, if your broad topic is gas sensor, then you will have to select 10 best journal. Ab 10 best journal kaise honge? Maine aapko bataya. 5 parameters maine, I have told you. Impact factor, site score, fire impact factor, Simagorang, HJR, and SNP. These are the 5 different parameters. So, aap dekhenge ke based on those 5 different parameters, you will be identifying 10th best journal. Most importantly, let me tell you, while identification of 10th best journal, you need to make sure that whatever journal you are identifying, maximum paper should be published in that journal from your area. Jaise ki maan lo, koi ek journal aapne identify kiya, jo that follows those 5 criteria, the impact factor is very high, but only 5% of research papers from your area are publishing in that journal. So that journal is not going to be good for you. Minimum 50% paper should be from your own research area. If that journal publishes at least 50% of paper from your area, then only that journal should be considered. And then you have to do national status, like national and international status, right? What is national status? Download at least 5 research paper of research scholar who are working in India in above mentioned topic. मतलब जो broad area जो आपका gas sensor का है, आपको क्या करना है कि India में जो काम कर रहे हैं, those who are working in India, okay? लेकिन ये gas sensor में काम कर रहे हैं, ऐसे कम से कम 5 paper ये base journal में से आप identify करो. And then what you have to do? Write down what, like understand, like read those paper carefully. Understand what are their objectives, what kind of methodology they have adopted, what kind of tools, oblique characterization techniques they have used for interpretation of their results, what are their main findings, what kind of shortcomings they have in their investigation. This is very, very important. What kind of shortcomings they have there in their investigation. Now, for this purpose, I would like to show you one research paper. I will be sharing another screen. Okay. Yes. Are you able to see this? Are you able to see this paper?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can see.
Yes, sir.
Whenever I ask you to download papers, then let us say this is one of the paper from Journal of Physical Chemistry. ये मेरा खुद का paper है. Right? आप ऐसे लिखेंगे Journal of Physical Chemistry. See, this is one of the very, very reputed journal. This, the title of paper is Porphyrin Functionalized Single Wall Carbon Nanotube Chemiresistive Sensor Array for VOCs. So this belongs to my, let us say, I want to work, my broad topic is gas sensor. So okay, this is from gas sensor. Then I will see the name of authors. Okay, so I said like five papers from those who are working in India. तो आप देखेंगे कि ये authors है, उसका appellation क्या है, right? Appellation में कहीं पर भी India दिख नहीं रहा, so this cannot be considered as a national status. National status में ये paper को मैं ले नहीं पाऊंगा. Although I am, because when I was in US, in the University of California in 2006 to 9, during that time I published this data, right? So you need to see like what is the appellation of these authors, right? Appellation से पता चलेगा कि ये paper India के author का है या नहीं है. Because this author says, like appellation says University of California, Riverside, University of California, Riverside, you know, this Arizona State University, Arizona. It means these are from, so this paper can be considered as a paper for international status, right? International status में क्या करना है आपको? आपको ऐसे पांच paper download करने हैं कि जो India के बाहर काम कर रहे हैं. So this could be one of the paper for international status. Okay, now let us say you identify this, right? इससे पता चलेगा कि whether this is from India or outside India. Then you read the abstract. Abstract से आपको पता चलेगा कि what they have done. I told you like you need to read, you need to understand what kind of research they have carried out, right? That can be understand through while going through abstract. Then what kind of research they got, that also can be understood from the abstract itself. तो उन्होंने क्या किया है, क्या रिजल्ट्स उनको मिले हैं, दैट कैन बी इजीली अंडरस्टूड थ्रू अब्स्ट्रैक्ट. नाउ एज फार एज टूल्स आर कंसर्न, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ टूल्स दे हैव यूज्ड, दैट कैन बी फॉर इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ डेटा, दैट कैन बी अंडरस्टैंड थ्रू मेथड्स एंड कैरेक्टराइजेशन. यू कैन से मेथड्स, नैनो सेंसर फैब्रिकेशन, देन गैस सेंसिंग स्टडीज. ओके, सो इससे आपको पता चल जाएगा कि उन्होंने क्या टूल्स यूज किए फॉर इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ देयर डेटा. ओके, एंड इफ यू गो टू द रिजल्ट्स, ओके, यू कैन सी द रिजल्ट्स. तो आपको प्रोमिनेंट उन्होंने क्या काम किया उसे पता चल जाएगा. एंड व्हेन यू गो टू द कंक्लूजन, यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर देयर ब्रॉड कंक्लूजन्स. ओके, व्हाट आर देयर ब्रॉड कंक्लूजन्स. तो क्या, जैसे मैंने बताया था, दिस इज हाउ द पेपर नीड टू बी रेड. ओके, दिस इज हाउ एनी पेपर नीड टू बी रेड. सो लाइक दैट यू नीड टू डाउनलोड 5 रिसर्च पेपर्स फ्रॉम इंडिया, फ्रॉम आवर स्कोपस इंडेक्स पेपर. दिस इज स्कोपस इंडेक्स पेपर from the researcher who are working in India, that is national status. And similarly, at least 5 papers, minimum 5, maximum you can go up to 10. Usually those who are coming to me, I advise them to collect 10 papers from national, from within India, and 10 outside India. So 20 papers, I usually advise student to go for 20 papers at least. Okay, because the whatever rigorous work you will be doing, it will, is going to be useful for you, right? So now I am going to share the another screen. Okay, so I was talking to you about this, right? ये मैं बता रहा था आपको कि from that paper you will be able to understand what are their objectives, methodology, what kind of tools, characterization technique they have used, what for interpretation of result, what are their main findings, what kind of shortcomings they have in their investigation, right? So like that, if there are 5 papers, there would be 5 paragraphs for each and every paper, 1 paragraph for each. And then similarly, you will have to do international, right? You will have to do the international status, right? So download minimum five papers from research scholar who are working overseas in above mentioned areas. Now, ये paper मैंने example के तौर पे दिया है. Okay. Now let me give you what kind of review you will have to do. Whenever we are talking about review, national or international. लेवल, तो जो भी आप एक पेपर पढ़ेंगे तो उसमें से कैसा आप पैराग्राफ लिखना है, दिस इज जस्ट एन एग्जांपल. सो आई हैव ड्राफ्टेड दिस पैराग्राफ फ्रॉम द पेपर व्हिच आई हैव शोन यू, राइट? यू कैन सी द सिरसाट एट अल हैव रिपोर्टेड केमी रेजिस्टिव सेंसर अरे फॉर डिटेक्शन ऑफ वीओसीज बाय यूजिंग पोरफिरिन फंक्शनलाइज्ड सिंगल वॉल कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब. दे हैव अलाइन एसडब्ल्यूएनटीज अक्रॉस 3 माइक्रोन गैप इन ऑन SiSiO2 सबस्ट्रेट बाय यूजिंग एसी electrophoretic alignment, and then as the SWNTs were modified by porphyrin by using solvent costing method. They have used array of 16 sensor to detect various VOCs, these are the VOCs, by using chemiresistive modalities. They have also used PCA to study selectivity of proposed sensor and sensor array, and shows excellent VOC discriminating capabilities of sensor array. So this particular paragraph reflect that what kind of objectives they were having, what kind of tools they use for interpretation of data, and what are their prominent reasons. Now, the last statement, I have identified the problem. As I mentioned earlier, whenever you will be referring paper, you will have to identify some problem, some lacuna. You can see the last statement. However, they have tested only saturated vapors of VOCs for device fabrication. Sensing VOCs at PPM/PPB level is very much needed, right? So what I have done, I have just identified one of the problem that they have done saturated vapors of those VOCs. They have not tested those VOCs at PPB or PPM level. So this is the problem, right? So like that, for each and every paper, let us say if there are five papers, there would be five paragraphs, and each paragraph you will be making, you will be identifying some issues for each and every. And then in the references, you can see Sirsan et al. Square bracket 1. It means I am referring this paper. And in the list of references, this would be my first paper. जिसमें वो author का नाम रहेगा, title of the paper रहेगा, and the journal का detail रहेगा, right? This is how it need to be cited in the references. Okay? So ये होगा national status and then international status, right? Then this is what the literature review is going to be. After literature review, you will be having fine-tuned topic. पहला broad topic क्या था? Gas sensor. Now you can see literature review से पता चला कि लोग क्या कर रहे हैं. What is happening elsewhere in the gas sensor? Now, what should be my investigation? What should be my steps? What should be my topic? You can see the fine-tuned topic would be now organic conducting polymer functionalized as WNTs for detection of aromatic gases. Right? My broad topic was only gas sensor. You can see this was my broad topic, gas sensor. But fine-tuned topic is now, you can see, organic conducting polymer functionalized as WNTs for detection of aromatic gases. मतलब this is ये कब मुझे पता चला कि organic conducting polymer, carbon nanotube, ये कब पता चला? Paper पढ़ने के बाद मुझे पता चला कि yes, carbon nanotube can be used for the one of the sensing material. Organic conducting polymer can be used for modification and it can be used for detection of BETEX. BETEX is a group of aromatic gases. This I could understand while going through the literature. That is why literature review is going to play a very important role. And then I will have to form the hypothesis. You can see what is, I told you earlier, what should be hypothesis? Hypothesis is kind of assumption, kind of prediction, but it should be tested. It should be testable. It should have some number. You can see the proposed work deals with the functionalization of SWNTs by organic conducting polymers for detection of BETEX. So this is what I'm going to do. The proposed sensor will have a lower detection limit of each of BTEC gases at par with OSHA-PEL level. So this is the exact number, right? OSHA-PEL ka, OSHA is Occupational Safety and Health Administration. It's like organization of US, which is looking after the monitoring of hazardous gases in the environment. PEL means permissible exposure level. तो ओशा का आप अगर डेटा चेक करोगे तो आपको सभी बीटेक्स गैसेस का, जितने भी बीटेक्स बेंजीन टोलीन, बीटेक्स मींस बेंजीन टोलीन इथिल बेंजीन एंड ज़ाइडीन, दीज आर द फोर डिफरेंट एरोमेटिक गैसेस, इसके ओशा पेल लेवल ऑलरेडी डिफाइन किया है ओशा ने. सो व्हाट आई एम प्लानिंग दैट माय लोअर डिटेक्शन लिमिट वुड बी एट पार विद दिस. नंबर वन, विद रिस्पॉन्स एंड रिकरेंट टाइम इज लेस देन 30 एंड 40 सेकंड रेस्पेक्टिवली. वेरी स्पेसिफिक, I'm not saying that less response time, very specific, 30 and 40 seconds. Stability of at least 60 days, sensitivity more than 60%, and selective to BTEX only. So this is what I'm expecting very specifically, and that becomes a testable statement. Yahan par agar number nahi rehte, toh this becomes open-ended, and this is an idea statement, but cannot be hypothesis. Maine jaisa aapko bataya. So you can see, like, whenever you say hypothesis, it means that it is a kind of prediction, but it has got some absolute number which can be tested, right? Aapka hypothesis hua, the next would be like objectives. Okay, you can see this is how the objectives can be written, right? Like you can see preparation of interdigitated electrode on SiO2 substrate having submicron gap between two micro electrode. ये कब पता चलेगा आपको? आपको जब वो लैब में आप जहां पर प्रोजेक्ट करना चाहते हो वहां पर आपको पता होना चाहिए कि what kind of facilities they have. Then only you will be able to write the objectives. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for you, right? That is why I said you need to go to the laboratory of various teachers, see what kind of facility they are having, what kind of research they are doing, then only you will be able to do this. Okay, second would be alignment of SWNT between two microelectrodes. जैसे कि यहाँ पर हाइपोथेसिस में मैंने क्या किया था, प्रपोज वर्ड डील्स विद फंक्शनलाइजेशन ऑफ SWNT बाय ऑर्गेनिक कंडक्टिव पॉलीमर फॉर डिटेक्शन ऑफ बिटेक्स. दिस वाज लाइक दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू डू, दिस इज व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू अचीव. तो कैसे करूंगा मैं वो स्टेप, लाइक व्हाट एवर आई वांट टू डू, व्हाट एवर आई एम टू अचीव, आई वुड लाइक टू अचीव फॉर रीचिंग माई डेस्टिनेशन, व्हाट शुड बी स्टेप्स दैट नीड टू बी फॉलोड, दिस इज व्हाट वी कॉल एज ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड यू कैन सी इट शुड बी इन बुलेट फॉर्म. Functionalization of SWNT by organic conducting polymers, then structural, spectroscopic, electrochemical, electrical, and morphological characterization of bare SWNT and OCP functionalized SWNT, and last one is evaluation of sensing properties by OCP functionalized SWNT devices for detection of bitex. So these are the objectives. Now, what is methodology? You can see. आप अगर objective और methodology में देखेंगे, objective there were 5 points. In methodology also there are 5 points. So if there are 5 points in objectives, there should be 5 points in methodology. Now you can see what is the difference. What is methodology? Methodology is the technique which you are going to use to achieve your objectives. Technique which you are going to use to fulfill your objectives. This is what the methodology is. And that is why you can see the same statement hai, preparation of interdigitated electrode on SiSO2 substrate by having submicron gap by photolithography technique. So technique I will be saying like aligning. ये देखिए यहाँ पर पहला statement as it is है objective में भी था alignment of SWNT between two microelectrode. It is same here alignment of SWNT between two microelectrode. But only technique I have mentioned alignment of SWNT is between two microelectrode by AC dye electrophoretic alignment. So this is technique. Similarly functionalization of SWNT is by organic conductive polymer. By using charge controlled potentiostatic definitions, potentiostatic method. So we are just mentioning here the method which we are going to use to achieve the objectives. And then structural characterization by XRD, spectroscopic characterization by UV, FKIR, and Raman, electrochemical characterization by CH electrochemical workstation, electrical characterization by Keithley SMU, morphological characterization by AFM and FESEM. Atomic force microscope and scanning electron microscope of bare and OCP functionalized SWNTs. यहाँ पर भी आपको पता होना चाहिए कि जिस लैब में आप काम कर रहे हो, what kind of facilities they are having, whether you will be able to do this, whether they have these facilities available, then only you will be able to write methodology. And then last one is, अब last देखिए, यहाँ पर था evaluation of sensing properties of OCP functionalized SWNT devices. Now here it would be evaluation of sensing properties of OCP. This is OCP actually. OCP functionalized SWNT devices for detection of bitex by chemiresistive and chemPET techniques. So essentially here, what we have done, we have mentioned the methods which we are going to use to detect to achieve the objectives. This is what the methodology is. And next would be expected outcome. So expected outcome कहाँ से आएगा? सीधा जो आपका hypothesis है ना, hypothesis का जो ये statement है, दूसरा statement. This will form your expected outcome. You can see. So you can see my expected outcome is the proposed sensor will have lower detection limit of each of bitex gases at par with Hochappel with response and recovery time less than 30 seconds and 40 seconds respectively. Stability of at least 60 days. Sensitivity more than 60% and selectivity to bitex only. This is what I'm expecting. Okay. And then references. Okay, so ultimately, I just wanted to tell you this is what you will have to do. Selection of broad topic. I give you example. What should be broad topic? Understanding of the topic. Literature review. International and national status. कैसे करना चाहिए? Fine tuning of the topic. Hypothesis कैसे होना चाहिए? Objectives, methodology, expected outcome and references. This is what you will have to do in semester two. I have given you one example as well, and this is how we end up with. The unit 3.